Cake or death is an obvious choice. I mean, cake. But being frozen in unproven cryonic technology or death? Hey y'all, Trace here for DNews. Kim Suozzi has joined the ranks of cryonic pioneers and become one of the few hundred people frozen in suspension only to be thawed out in the far future. Kim found out she had terminal brain cancer when she was in her early 20s, and on her 23rd birthday, she posted on Reddit, what should she do with the last few months of her life? And the Redditors had thousands of comments, from try LSD to run up, you know, huge debt on your credit card. But there were comments also about cryonic preservation. Her interest was piqued, and soon, with the help of some small donations from Redditors and some big donations from some nonprofits, she had enough money to cryonically preserve her entire body. Science fiction has long talked about hypersleep or stasis or cryosleep or whatever it's called, and that technology does exist today, but it's less than perfect. The scientific term for this is not cryogenics, but cryonics. Cryogenics is studying anything that's kept really cold. But if you put something living into suspension, that's cryonics. As of last weekend, Kim finally succumbed to her cancer and was deanimated. That's what the cryonic people call it. And then she was put into preservation. Here's how it works. First, you're deanimated, and then your body is cooled rapidly so that you get to a very cold temperature without damaging too many of the tissues, if you can help it. Then you're put into liquid nitrogen, and you're left there for a long time. People put themselves in suspension for a variety of reasons. Anything from fear of death, love of life, hope for a cure for their disease, curiosity about the future, or even wanting to be immortal. The thing is, we've got no way to reanimate people that have been deanimated. The problem with the technology at the moment is that our cells are full of water. And when you freeze water, it expands and creates crystals, and that bursts the cell membranes. So once we would be thawed out, we'd kind of just turn into mush. That doesn't really stop people from trying it, though. Their rebuttal is that in the future, the far future, whenever that would be, they'll know how to fix it.
We'll see who's right, I guess.
I mean, we won't see who's right. They'll see who's right. There is a separate process called vitrification. That's when you replace the liquid inside of your cells with this chemical cocktail that doesn't freeze and burst the membranes. It's been proven to work on a variety of small bits, like, you know, cells and organs that are really small, but not a whole anything. Cryonics have been around for a while. The first institute started in the 1960s in my home state of Michigan. You're welcome, science. Since then, only a few others have popped up, but they are mostly vilified for being frauds and shysters because the technology is unproven and no one has seen anybody successfully reanimated. Because of that, most of the people that work in these nonprofit organizations are do-it-yourselfers, part-timers, or just volunteers. So when you think of cryonics, you probably think of slick, see-through canisters with people floating, suspended in bubbly fluid. But it's not like that at all. In fact, it's more like this. Homemade gizmos and freezers and basements. Don't feel bad for Kim Suozzi. She did have her doubts, but she said that you had to have faith in technology. Would you cryonically freeze yourself? I know it's winter and it's probably already cold enough outside and you don't really want to think about it, but, you know, let us know. Why or why not? Down in the comments. Easy to do. Also, subscribe to DNews. Don't give us the cold shoulder. It's really easy. Just click that little button up there and you won't regret it. We promise. Thanks for watching, everybody. 7 days of videos, 2 videos a day. See you next time.